All right, in this video, let's do what is essentially new to me. I want to create the layout of the page using CSS grids. And as I said, I'm just starting to learn about them, but they're so much easier to deal with than anything I've done in the past that I really like them. I'm very excited. So here's what we got so far. We got our home page, click on news. It's basically the same way we left it in the last video. And now is actually surround this with a div and give it a class of wrapper, or no, I like to call it container. Sometimes I call it wrapper, but container right now. And I want to put this inside it. So here's the, from here to here, whatever we put inside there is going to be in the container. And actually I want to put this inside a div too. Let's see, I'm going to put this inside there. And I want another. And then we'll make a number of them. So right here I want to have like a picture area, and right here maybe a caption area. I'm just imagining if you made a web page where you're displaying some pictures, another area two. So if you look at it right now, be on the index page, all we have is just that. So no styling has been applied, but we do have it inside this container class. If we go over here and create a container, container. And by the way, this dot, the reason I put a dot is because I'm using a class. If you call it a class, then you have to put a dot. If you call it an ID, then you have to put a hashtag. So right now it's a container dot, say display grid. That's how you tell it to start displaying as a grid. And then we say grid template columns. Let's see, template columns. I'm going to do one fraction, two fraction, one fraction, just for starters. And let's see what that does, if it does anything. Yeah, so it's starting to throw things around. And to make it easier to see what's going on, we go like this, container, div. We tell it everything inside the container that's a div. We want the background color. Let's give it something simple like CCC. That's just a grayish color. Now there's all the gray, but it's still kind of hard to see the individual areas. So I'm going to do container div, and I want to say nth styled odd. If you do that and then you say background color a different color like EEE, then it basically does every other one no matter how many divs you add. Like you could add more areas and it will just automatically alternate the colors. So really cool how it does that automatically. And then I want to do, let's see, I'm going to peek because I haven't memorized these codes yet. I want this and I want that. So I'm going to say, let me not apply too many things at once. This line of code, grid auto rows, min max, it basically tells it you want a minimum height of, and this should be px, 200 pixels, and then the maximum should just be auto. By doing that, 200, maybe I should make it 100, see what that does. It makes them not quite as big. And that auto takes care of this little problem. If you did something, like, let's see, lorem, I think, lorem 40. There, now I got quite a bit of text automatically written. If you notice that, it pushed down. Maybe I should have done a larger quantity, so like 100 tab. So what you do there, in case, I guess I should have explained it. If you write lorem and then put a number, like 100, and then hit tab, code anywhere will automatically generate some fake text. And so what I want you to see is that it automatically pushes the stuff down. And if we didn't do that, it would actually spill out of the box. So this little piece of code right here is pretty good to have. And then if I uncomment this, the 0.5 gap, if I refresh, you can see now it shows just a little gap and looks really nice. So that's the beginnings of getting the grid thing to work. And we'll continue adding more features in the next video.